seconds to go. Hello to the two fans and welcome to Chicago Ted coming to you pretty late, but nonetheless, we are starting this one. It's going to be T-Show going up against Team Leviathan for the Suit American Master 3, second best of three series for the day. Of course, I am not alone. This time around, I'm being joined by Spudnik, and I just got to unmute my mic there and say hello. How you doing, Spudnik?
Hey, how's it going, man? It's good to be here after waiting for like 3 days.
3 days? That's an understatement. We've been at least here since the beginning of time.
Sounds about right.
All right, so we're going into this one. Looks like we do have a reserve time penalty on Team T-Show, though not a huge one. I guess it's adequate for the one-hour delay that we just experienced. Either way, let's hear your thoughts initially for these two teams. You familiar with any of them?
Well, I had very little notice, so I was going to research them, but I just got completely lazy and didn't do it in our hour delay. I know a little bit about Leviathan, so... Well, I mean, we'll see how they do. I have no idea about T-Show, and I see no history, so do you have any idea who they are?
Well, I do. I've seen them twice before in this tournament, but both times were before the patch update, so I have no idea. It's like a fresh new kind of thing. You don't exactly know what they're doing after that. But I know these guys are very experienced. They're all pretty well known, and I think, though don't quote me on this, they are the reincarnation of an older, more popular team, whether it was Pain Gaming or something like that. So they're pretty well known and they're pretty accomplished, but Leviathan, as we all know, is one of the better NA kind of semi-pro teams, and they're doing a really good job across all boards, so I'm really looking forward to seeing their play as well.
5 seconds.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I just hope we don't see a TA, which we're likely to see.
Yeah, we are very likely to see. We already saw one once today. That was the best of three series that happened earlier on. That was going to be, oh god, I can't remember the teams now. I'm just like, I've been waiting so long, it's really gotten to my brain. It was Dialcom against Unknown Zoo. There we go. And we saw a Templar Assassin that absolutely dominated. I'm talking like 600, 700 GPM at the end of the game. But aside from that, we've got a couple picks coming out. T-Show with the Winter Wyvern Night Stalker and Team Leviathan picking themselves up the Lich. So... I know all three of these picks are very well sought after. Still no Clockwork, no Earthshaker yet, but we could still see those in this game. So what thoughts do you have so far about this draft, at least in the early stages? Where do you think both teams are going to kind of go with this as far as their aggression levels, their play styles?
Well, I hope Jenkins gets his Pudge, obviously, and just goes ham, like, the entire game. Radiant just completely man. Off the walls bonkers. But,
Yeah, I'm hoping for the Pudge. Don't worry. We all hope for the Jenkins Pudge, and we only see it when Leviathan pretty much, like, the only times I've seen it are pretty much when Leviathan know they're going to win. Like, they'll pick it in, like, a game two of a stomp series where they destroyed in game one, and they'll just, like, go ham with it. But I think sometimes most game ones, they err on the safe side, though I would like to see it come out. The Lich, the Doom, a much more standard, a much more safe combination, and pretty devastating at that.
Yeah, I mean, Doom, just never a hero you want to play with. Just, you're not a hero for, like, as long as he's near you. It's so ridiculous to play against.
It is. I mean, these guys, they've got a lot of power. Doom can tank up really early. He's very hard to kill. And Lich can demolish really any lane just by being able to take away all that experience from the enemy core. And the experience and gold both make a difference, but it allows you to keep the wave equilibrium constantly pushing onto your side of the map and really forces the carry to struggle with either creep control or just staying near enough to the wave to get really anything out of it.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's just very frustrating to play against, especially if you can't really group up, because that Lich ult is just going to bounce for days. And if he ever gets the farm to get an eggs, I mean, that's just no fun.
All right, so we've got a Spectre ban out, an Anti-Mage ban out, Tinker and Batrider both gone. Where do you think we go with this? I mean, T-Show, again, the Winter Wyvern, the Night Stalker, Earthshaker has not been picked or banned yet. You think that's a sought-after pick for these guys?
10 seconds to go.
It could be. I mean, it's always a good support, or you can even run it as, like, that core, like, Crit Shaker, but you never know.
Reserve time. Yeah, I mean, again, I haven't seen these guys in the new patch, so I'm not entirely familiar with their drafting style, but we've been seeing very similar to the same things over and over again, though. Io, that's one that's coming out. That's been seen quite a bit recently. Who is it? Monkey Business. I don't think it does. That picked it up a lot.
Yeah, I don't think it necessarily got any like buffs or nerfs, but it's just, it's felt very strong again this last patch, especially with the Tinies coming back out.
Right, and
been seeing a lot more IO Tiny.
Do you think they're going to be going for that combination, the IO Tiny here, or do you think they're going to go something a little bit more left field?
I mean, it's entirely possible. It's again, very hard to deal with. You give them a little bit of space, you get that eggs, then you're just knocking on tier 3s, tier 4s in no time.
5 seconds.
Yeah, it's going to be hard. But Leviathan, they can pick Bannett right now. I don't think they will, and they won't. They'll go for the Witch Doctor, known to be a fairly good counter to the IO, allowing you to get that paralyzing cask off and really halting the action, whether it be an aggressive lane or later on in the game when the relocates come through. But Tisho, they grab themselves an Ember Spirit, which is kind of surprising considering this is a very mobile hero on its own, though. It could be still be their mid-pickup and allowing them to grab a more greedy one-position carry, but it could also just be an IO Ember combo, which we don't see often, and maybe to good reason.
Yeah, I don't necessarily think it's going to be IO Ember, but between the Ember and the Night Stalker, they have a very gank-heavy lineup. They can do some work around the 4-minute mark and going on from there, and it could snowball out of control pretty quickly.
Yeah, the whole big thing about this is snowballing, too. It's more or less, right now, Team Leviathan, they've got a very scary lineup in Tisho. They've got to get off the ground very quickly. Nightstalker has trouble playing from behind. Winter Wyvern, not so much, but is still pretty squishy. I guess you can come back a little bit with the Winter's Curse, but even then, sometimes it ends up not being enough of a lockdown Lena. If you don't have much follow-up damage. So Leviathan, they'll grab themselves the Lena, which leads me to believe that that will probably be their mid laner. So who do they go for this last pick?
I don't know. They need a lot of, like, they need like a solid hard carry here. But
think it's
going to
be Chilon, Quaz, Phantom Lancer.
I mean, it could be. It could be anything. Like, there are a lot of pretty solid hard carries out there still left. So
yeah, there are. The Anti-Mage is gone, though. The Spectre is gone. Those two are more generally the ones that are picked up nowadays. Spectre especially, but the Phantom Lancer gets banned out by Tisho, and leads me to believe they're scared of the burst damage again with the IO on the map. Makes a little bit of sense. I guess what Leviathan could be looking for is someone that can burst down that IO very quickly alongside, well, not, without even having to focus him, which sometimes a Battle Fury PA can do. Just get a crit on someone else and the IO, wherever he is, just blows up. But
5 seconds.
I don't know. Still got the lane, although they can blow up the IO pretty easily, I still think.
Yeah, well, do you really want to spend the... Okay, you don't actually have to spend the Laguna to blow up the IO.
Yeah,
I just thought about that when I said
QW, and it's gone.
Yeah, plus maybe they've got right the paralyzing click. Cask, they've got the Chain Frost. There's a lot of bouncing spells, too. So anyone that's paired up with that IO is going to have a very bad day.
Absolutely.
So we're looking for our last ban here from Team Leviathan. Taking a little bit of time, though. It looks like their final ban could be geared either towards a one-position carry, if they think the Ember Spirit's going to be playing mid, or a mid laner, which they could still run a dual mid Tiny, and Leviathan might put a stick in the spokes if they were to ban it out right now. Again, though, it seems a little bit obvious, but they will do it.
Dire's pick.
Well, I mean, it's very strong, and the Ember can easily run safe lane. I mean, it's not really that big of a deal.
Quick nitpick, do you happen to have open mic on?
Yeah, I do. I can close
you
that.
You do. Because the in-game viewers are saying they cannot hear you.
Oh. I might not have it on in-game.
We'll have to see. Either way, I figured this would have come out at one point or another. Chaos Knight gets picked up by Tisho. Of course, you got a little bit of a change, That was a hell of a change with the minus armor now applying on his crit. Do you think this makes the hero, or do you think he's still a little trashed here in the pro scene?
I mean, I don't think I've seen it run too much on the pro scene, but I've seen it a lot more in pubs recently, and I'm not too familiar with the changes because I haven't looked over the patch notes in like super depth.
Pretty much, instead of a flat crit, they reduced the crit percentage and added a minus armor reduction.
Okay, I mean, I can see it being good with the IO. You get that accelerated attack speed, you get the mana and HP regen. I mean, it can be very good.
Reserve time. I agree. I mean, I'm scared of him. I'm scared of him in pubs. I'm scared to see him in the pro scene. I think he's got potential to be a really, really strong player. But, of course, there is still that factor that you actually have to see it to really fully understand, at least for most people, me included. So we will be able to see it this game whether or not it's strong. But the big thing here, though, is that they do have plenty of ways to deal with groups of heroes between the Lina's Lightstrike Array, the Paralyzing Cask. Though Leviathan are going to grab themselves a Medusa. And this is interesting for multiple reasons. I think the main one being they're going up against a Chaos Knight. By the way, for a warning, guys, this will probably crash when we load up. So don't be surprised if I get out. If this doesn't crash, then I love Valve. They did fix it.
That was why the patch was so big.
I hope the patch fixed it. They said it fixed it the other day. It didn't actually fix it. The update came out right before a game I casted. I got in the game. First thing, I crashed, and I was very sad. So I don't know. My fingers are crossed right now, but it's looking like it can go either way. The hype is getting real as Lich. They still got to put their hero on it. What do you think, by the way? Team Leviathan, it looks like they've only got the one stand-in, Mr. Chi, Long Qua. Is this their strongest lineup right now?
I don't think it's necessarily their strongest lineup, but I mean, it can be very strong if they can make it past like the early game, because you get that little snowball, and it's very hard to stop it.
All right, well, now I got to wait for the game to load in. So in the meantime, we've got a little bit of Radio Dota going around. Any final thoughts about these two drafts? Who do you favor, at least for the early game?
I probably shouldn't throw my hat in the ring because I'm a little fanboy, but I'm going to go with Leviathan.
I agree. It's not like a fanboy kind of thing, too. I do feel like Leviathan is a little bit more of a more consistent team.
We might actually get a little bit of action.
Go for it. Radio
Bay from T-Show coming down. They might catch on to Chalonqua if they walk into him.
Come on, dude. What are the sights and the sounds? Let's get the radio going.
I don't think they're going to get him now. Just little invade. No, they do get him. You should get back in the game, though, because I'm terrible.
Most casual radio cast I've ever seen. Yeah, they do get him. Okay.
Yeah, it was good. It was good. Right. They did stuff, man. They caught him.
Wait, they did? There's no kills.
No, there's no kills, but they caught him with the W from Chaos Knight.
All right. This is the things you got to be thinking about, you know, for that time you launch your Radio Dota career. Definitely some pro
definitely
tips coming
not
in.
Happen, but yeah, I should probably learn what the spells are called.
Probably.
You know, we did the thing, man.
Did some stuff.
Yeah.
It was good. Anyway, 50-50 split on the Bounty Runes. Leviathan will grab the top. Shibby's going to take that one. CYS, sorry. That's a different player and a different team. He grabs the Bounty Rune at the bottom. Speaking of CYS, he's going to be the first player for T-Show. He's going to be on that Ember Spirit. Shortly behind him, it's Littlekin on the Winter Wyvern with the bottom lane. We're looking at Therence playing the Chaos Knight with King RD, the big man on the Little Isle. And finally, Baga closing it out on the Night Stalker. You want to take Leviathan?
All right, so we got in the bottom lane CLQ, Mr. Francis himself on the Medusa. You got Nushim on that Witch Doctor. You got Flying Zebra on his Lich that I've never seen before. And you got Shibby on a great Lina. And then you got Jenkins on your Doom.
Yeah, it's just Jenkins. No one cares.
Yeah, it's just Jenkins doing, stuff.
Yeah, Shibby rocking the Arcana, too. He's having a ball on this Lina in the mid lane. Favoring the lane. I would put this a little bit more towards Lina, at least for the early parts of the game. Littlekin wanted to show that he was looking for a gank, but what exactly does a Winter Wyvern do except for a little bit of slow? Shibby was playing a pretty far back position. Doesn't have the Observer Ward. In fact, that is T-Show's Observer Ward. So it wasn't Shibby getting the vision for that. Actually, it looks like we might have a little bit of engagement. Top, Littlekin searching, but not going to find anything.
You already got a salve down on your Ember Spirit, so he's burning through his regen pretty fast, doing that Lino stuff, you know?
Yeah, Baga actually is going to put the Void onto Jenkins. He might be in a bit of trouble here. The Arctic Burn's going to end, and the movement speed debuff will go down. So Jenkins is able to get away, playing very far forward. He actually doesn't care. He's got casually 25% HP, and yet he's still being active in this pull that has been pulled out by him. So it's no fear on the Doombringer. As that is a very weird headset. I don't think I've ever seen that before.
Yeah, I mean, that stout shield, ring of protection, 3 armor, you're doing like 0 damage to him. He's taking so much abuse and just not even caring.
Yeah, he's got a Scorched Earth, 2 points up in that. He's got it ready to cast whenever he wants it. So if I ever feel like he's taking a bit more damage, he can just pop that. And really, how do you damage him through that? It ends up being, well, again, you literally do no damage.
Yeah, bringing that old meme back.
It is. He is exactly the person that meme was originally created, right?
Hey, it was Doom. Well, there plus one go. Armor, literally no damage. Swag.
Jenkins. Just as we say that, Caster's Curse, he might be in trouble. No, he's regening through it all.
Okay, back to the original point. No damage.
No damage, yep. They were doing some damage, and then it turned to negative damage. So
looks like they're going to get Chaos Knight down bot.
They're trying. Therence is still pretty healthy, though. New Gem. Oh, they're going to actually pull him back. They want to get New Gem. Therence, he just needs a couple more right clicks, but the Voodoo Restoration is helping keeping him online. And Therence, he's got enough mana for another Chaos Bolt, but it's on cooldown, so he can't quite cast it. Still, 3 minutes into the game with no First Blood.
So we get nothing but delays and super regen and nobody dies. This is going to be a great series.
Yeah, I know, right? I mean, it happens. It happens. I've waited 50 minutes for a game to start, like today, and all three games were like 50-plus minutes.
That's one of those games where you just know, like, somebody hates you.
Exactly. And, like, you know, you have work the next day, you got to get up early in the morning, and you get up and you're dead. You're trying to drink that coffee, but it's just not doing anything for you. Anyway, this is not very Dota-oriented chat here. Somewhat relevant. But we're looking 3.5, now approaching 4 minutes with no First Blood. Maybe that changes in the top lane. Flying Zebra, he can't really fly away. He's moving super slow. Baga will bring him down. Now Littlekin could be in a bit of trouble. They're looking for the return kill. Meanwhile, King RD dies to Qilong Kwa in the bottom lane. So while Jenkins is trying to deal damage in the top, a kill happens in the bottom. It is the Isle, though, so a little bit more expected. I imagine that came off the back of a paralyzing cask, but 1-1 now. All of a sudden, we see a couple of kills drop down.
Yeah, I think that was just Mystic Stake, Paralyzing Cask, and easy kill after that. They were both pretty low, like, for that whole laning phase, so.
Yeah, I mean, they were riding the low HP points, too, when we last looked at them before we looked away to the top lane, so.
I also missed it, so. Well, I'm bad, but you have no excuse.
No excuse for what?
No excuse for missing that kill. I have an excuse.
What do you mean? I was watching the top lane.
Yeah, exactly.
Kills are happening up top.
Yeah, but you gotta watch them both, man. Come on.
Oh my god.
Step your game.
Oh, I caught that one. Somewhat, actually. Barely. It looks like Shibby's able to bring down Sis with Laguna Blade cast. That is one hell of a kill for Shibby to get. 1v1 in the mid lane gives him plenty of room to start getting in some pretty heavy advantage. I mean, if I were Shibby, I'd take it.
Oh yeah, I mean, once Lina hits level 6, it's very hard to stop that, especially when you're riding low life. Just gonna R you and goodbye. Let's go back to base.
Exactly. Now 40 seconds till that Laguna Blade is back online. Could just, you know, wait a little bit and then do the same exact thing if they're not careful. But it looks like Sissy wants to go to the bottom lane this time, going on to Qilong Kwa, who is taking a lot of damage on this Medusa. The mana shield helping out. It won't help her forever. Trying to run away, but that last swipe of the club from Therence will bring an end to the stone-gazing Medusa. And that's a decent kill for Tisha to get on this bottom lane, as maybe they lose something. And comes Shibby looking to blow up King RD, though it is a fairly easy kill. New Sham, though, underneath the tier 1 tower. He's still alive. The Voodoo Restoration being a hell of a lot for them to burst through. Though Baga goes into the back lines. In comes Shibby with Laguna Blade back up and running. Could he throw it out? It looks like he wants to. He gets it. Zap. Shibby will find another kill. Baga now on the run. There isn't much more burst to bring him down, so he'll just run away.
But meanwhile, Jenkins casually cutting top lane.
Yeah, casually indeed. Lilkin, what does he exactly do against this Doombringer right now? If he shows up, he just gets doomed.
Yeah, I mean, he's got to stay back there, and he knows, so he doesn't
Jenkins.
Even have a TP. He should be dead.
Jenkins is just going to go ham on it. CYS does have a TP, but doesn't go to the top lane. Doesn't look like anyone's really coming up to help. They've got a TP on the Chaos Knight, but they're not going to do it. Lilkin's just going to die. First Doom used, Jenkins just casually picking up a kill and walking away. Gets away with murder. Meanwhile, back towards the mid lane, CYS will bring down Flying Zebra, but it will be a return as King RD. There's no running away from Shibby. Once you've dove the tier 1 tower, there is no turning back. And so Shibby gets a little bit of a return kill. Not much of a Pyrrhic victory, as it is a support for a support. But in the end, 1-for-1s aren't exactly sought after in the early parts of the game, so taking a look at how the net worth is ending up, though. Leviathan pulling ahead about 3,000 net worth experience, around the same margin. So at this point, you know, looking at the lanes, who is the real benefiter of this lane? I know it's obviously Leviathan with the advantage, but does this cue into their draft a lot, or do you think Tisha is getting enough out of this to do something?
I don't think they're getting enough out of this. I mean, CK feels like he's so far behind, and this Wisp is just getting blown up when Lina comes, like, anywhere near the same side of Madison, so that just feels way too squishy for what they're doing.
Yeah, we talked about, you especially talked about in the draft, it was This Lina, I mean, you don't even need a hard carry to burst down the aisle. You just, he just kind of goes down whenever the Lina's in somewhat of a proximity. And half the time, I don't even think Shibby really is planning on going on the aisle. It just kind of happens somewhat.
You accidentally hit him with a Dragon Slave, and oh wait, he's down.
Yeah, exactly. He just straight up dies. So Shibby, Laguna Blade is back up. You saw he was kind of hinting at the Lightstrike Array over on the CYS, but wasn't able to get it out and connect, so he attack animation cancels it, or cast animation cancels it, and just goes right back to farming. Meanwhile, Baga getting very aggressive in Leviathan's jungle, but not really any backup for him.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't feel like he's done enough during these nighttimes. He's already used this ult. He's already had one nighttime. They've gotten, what, like two kills out of it? It just doesn't feel like he's gotten enough out of this Night Stalker.
Yeah, didn't we mention in the draft, he just doesn't exactly come back incredibly well. So it is nighttime.
Yeah, if you're not snowballing, you're way far behind.
Exactly. So it is nighttime, and he needs to try to find some kills here. But Shibby, the positioning on him is so damn good. Hanging up on the high ground, they're trying to scout him out with the IO illusions, looking for something. But he is far enough away that they're not going to be able to grab any kills off this. And Leviathan are pretty much just controlling the map. They've got all three lanes farming in pretty well. And Tisho, they look like they're trying to stack up, you know, pull some advantage out of this their jungle. But for the moment, it's just they're not finding enough gold on the map to really make their time useful.
Yeah, when you got the top three cores out farming everyone on Tisho's side, like, it's not very well. Like, it's very foreboding.
Foreboding indeed. Jenkins now, let's take a look at some of his items. He went for a Hand of Midas. So the double farming style on Jenkins with the Tranquil Boots, allowing him to move really quickly. Not opting for the Blink, at least not yet, which is more of a standard pickup for the Doombringer, allowing him to jump in and get the ultimate on anyone he wants. Holding on to it because I feel like he thinks he's got enough of an advantage for this part of the game that he doesn't need to. In fact, he just goes in, walks up, and dooms Therence. And Therence is just straight up dead. They're keeping a couple in. Jenkins could actually fall for this one, but do you think a carry for himself is worth it here?
Not as far as that as he is. Yeah, he's got a TP out, and he's going to make it.
All right, so Therence not actually dying. A smart move from Jenkins, but maybe.
But I mean, forcing two TP rotations, that alone is pretty good. Because you have the whole rest of the map just clear. I mean, you got CLQ farming, like, uncontested. This Night Stalker can do nothing against him. And this tower is going to go down in short order.
Medusa can get rather unkillable really, really quickly, too. So it could be a little bit of a problem. They're letting Qilongqua farm freely, as you said. And every single time I've seen Qilongqua, by the way, it almost seems like this exact scenario happens. He always gets this sort of free lane to get some gold. Do you think that's just him playing really well, or they just forget about him?
It's him playing really well, but it's also Jenkins putting a lot of pressure on the rest of the map, and Shibby doing the same thing. Like, they're going in right now at 3 for him, and free lane for the Dusa.
They might not actually get him. He's able to turn around, gets the Laguna Blade out, will burn through the Flame Guard, but not going to do much else. Tisho, Gassist, he's trying to get himself away, and he will be able to. There's a Death Ward committed. It's not going to be able to find anything, so Shibby goes down, and wouldn't you know it, it's King RD, the one to actually bring him down. Almost poetic justice. Meanwhile, Therence, again in the top lane, a level death. He'll turn around and get the Chaotic Cabal off on him. He's actually going to get the kill. Therence turns around, mans up, and with the help of King RD, is able to punish Jenkins pretty heavily. And perhaps a lack of respect or just not expecting the rotation coming in, whichever the case, he will drop, and Tisho will even up the kill score.
Also, super caster's curse. As soon as I'm like, yeah, they're doing good all over the place, and then they just crumble all over the place. CLQ could have gone down too easily, but they didn't quite make the connection.
Plus, this is a pretty fast Medusa. 340 movement speed with the phase boots bumps up to a decent amount, so if she catches a small glimpse, even though it is nighttime, the night vision of... Actually, her night vision is decreased as well over the Fear Darkness or Create Darkness. I can't remember what it's called, but...
It's called Night Stalker O'Clock, I believe.
It's... Okay, I'm actually going to look. It's just darkness. Wow. I was like 50% there both times. Whatever. Aside from that, that vision reduction is pretty big, and I'm surprised Qilongqua was actually able to read that situation and get away as efficiently as he did. So, plus some advantage for Leviathan, but in the end, a lot of pressure is being put on this bottom tier 1 tower.
Yeah, they should get it. No one's rotating in quite yet. But again, Jenkins still just casually farming their jungle, casually pushing it into the 2-2.
Yeah, he got punished for it last time, but you know, if it
well, you got all five bot.
It works. Yeah. Oh yeah, and they've got all five bottom exactly. So, D-Show, you know, they've grouped up. They should get this tier one tower. They might be losing a little bit of map advantage everywhere else for it, but it looks like they're doing a pretty decent job of farming up Leviathan's jungle, though. Qilanqua, in preparation for this, clears out this hard camp stack just to be sure that T-Show do not find it and snipe it away from them. And at the moment, I mean, I'm not going to say that T-Show are looking as bad as they did a couple moments ago. They have been able to find a couple of pickoffs, but and a full on engagement, which I don't think Leviathan will take because Qilanqua being a Medusa kind of dissuades that. But given a full 5-on-5 engagement, who do you think will win at this point?
I mean, I'm still going to have to go with Leviathan. They have just too many AoE alts that are just too big, and T-Show are just way too squishy at the moment.
All right, I'll hold you to that one. So it looks like we might see a little bit of a bungle in the jungle, though. It's going to fizzle out, T-Show. They turn around, they back themselves off. Sis is going to farm pretty aggressively, but he's got the Remnant, so he can activate if he ever feels like he's in trouble. Has to be careful of the Doom coming in, however. Jenkins actually is making his way down bottom, going for the rush ag, so again, skipping Blink entirely. Do you agree with this decision at all?
I mean, I like it, but I'm a bad player, so. As long as you can just run him, stay on top of him, that Doom's going to last forever, and it's very depressing to take a hero out of the fight completely and make him useless.
See, the trick is to never say you're a bad player. Always, like, talk like you're some 7k MMR pro, because people will have confidence in you.
Oh,
now that
no,
you said that, you're going to get flamed like hell.
All we do is talk about how bad we are.
Oh, okay.
Because no one plays that game.
I'll give it to you. So, in your opinion, you like the no blink right now, and you know, it is working out pretty decent for him, but I still would like to see some way for him to get up and get the dooms off as a sort of initiation. It doesn't look like anyone else in his team really has that power to just start the fight. They mostly have to wait back and counter initiate when it comes onto them, unless, you know, Shibby's able to pull out a decent Yule's pick. But even that, with a kind of nerfed Yule's range, maybe that's a little bit harder nowadays.
Did they nerf the Yule's range?
I'm pretty sure they did. Am I wrong?
No, I didn't know that. That's what I get for not reading patch notes.
This is what I get for not having confidence in myself. Anyway, Shibby will be smoked up going down to the bottom lane. He'll make his way, and he'll find Sis. And Dust will get revealed. He goes in for the Yules. And Shibby. Oh! Oh, the timing was not quite on point. Now Therence is going to pull Shibby back and punish this heavily. Maybe not. Qilanqua comes in, but the balls are coming through and they're hurting, but they're not killing. King RD trying to teabag that Lina, not quite being able to successfully do so. Now Sis caught a little bit out. His Remnant spotted, so he doesn't really have any escape unless Jenkins kind of walks at him and foregoes that Remnant entirely. So Jenkins?
Nah, yeah, he's just going to farm it up. Didn't need
why
that
not?
Anyways.
Death Ward comes out. Theron's in trouble. He actually eats the full duration of it. And Nusham, he's just dancing around. King RD goes down to the last hit of the Death Ward. And Nusham grabbing a double kill. Looks like he's going to pay for it, but even if you kill him, I mean, is that really retribution? It looks like they're not even going to get him.
They're not even
going to
go for it.
Oh, boy.
I mean, that was 100% worth
it. More than 100% worth it. How does that even get both kills? That was like the last possible hit of that Death Ward is the one to kill the Io.
Like the one time you won Maledict, but I mean, he didn't even need it. Just enough damage. It was beautiful.
And he's going to have an Urn. Now, Urn and Maledict might have a pretty decent synergy together if he's able to get a couple of charges in. I never actually thought about that, but now that I think about it here, it seems like a pretty decent pickup. Plus, it looks like Leviathan are figuring they're stronger right now, so they might start to try to take a couple of heavy fights. They don't have that mechanism out just yet, or at least I don't think they
do. No,
they don't.
But they do just have so much sustain. Yeah, with the Urn plus Voodoo.
Alright, so T-Show have bought two hands of Midas. One for Baga, one for Theorix. What are your thoughts on this?
I mean, they need it to catch up, but it's just... it's not going to help them for the next 20 minutes, and they need it to win early.
Well,
that's when
we'll
weakest,
see
right
if
now.
It helps. I mean, I agree with you there. I don't think it quite has enough impact right now, but if Leviathan decide to just sit back and farm up for 20 minutes, hey, maybe it could pay off. But I think at that point, you're kind of worried about Nightstalker really falling off. Even if he does snowball, he does start to kind of take a second seat to most other hard carries. And I don't think Leviathan are that scared of farming up because they still have Chilan Kwa on this Medusa.
Radiant's mid tower's coming up.
Yeah, he's just... You don't even see him. He's just off farming.
And although his farm isn't entirely spectacular, he is still top three on the net worth and beating out every core of Tisho. So, all in all, not bad. Not the fastest farming, but it's still pretty good. Of course, he'll be behind the Doom, who is both the Hand of Midas and Devour. I mean, you don't out-farm this Doom.
Yeah, you don't beat that.
18 minutes, he's got Aghanim's, Tranquil Boots, and Hand of Midas. I mean,
top
you get Doom, what do you even do about that? You have to hope that someone on your team has enough damage to deny you, but at this point, I'm not even sure they've got that.
Yeah, Leviathan's got that nuke in case they try to deny. I mean, I don't see it happening, but it could.
Yeah, you always have to keep an open mind. I mean, half the time, you don't expect a courier to steal your kill. Or not a courier. That'd be weird if a courier could steal your kill. A neutral steal
amazing.
Your kill. And then the Satyr comes in and decides to throw a shockwave, and all of a sudden, you're out three kills and wondering what the hell just happened. Always be mindful of that Satyr, dude.
I mean, I still think it'd be amazing if couriers could attack and steal kills.
Remember Dagon couriers?
I don't play Dota. I play League. Sorry.
Oh, now you're really going to get flamed by chat. I think it'd be worse if you said I played Han, but...
Oh, I do play Han. It's a good
oh,
game.
There you go. You're screwed now. GG, well played. It's going to be a remnant out as Baga is hiding back waiting for Jenkins, but I don't think Baga can initiate on this. I mean, there's a tier 2 being pressured pretty heavily top. It will go down, and Tisho are trying to trade out a tier 2 bottom, but they don't get it. They can't get it. Meanwhile, Jenkins... If he gets this Doom off, this is a dead Nightstalker, and it looks like, yep.
Yeah.
There's no way he lives through this.
Unless his whole team is there. He might have to trade his
try
life.
For the deny. Just after you say they're not going to get the deny off, looks like they will do it. Actually, they're going to bring him back to base, maybe. They're healing him up with King RD. Jenkins! Okay. Death Ward. Baga's dead. In the end, he still will fall. Chain Frost will fly. Theron's only getting the slow off. The Yule Scepter up. They're going to chain off the Lightstrike Array. Trying to get that Chaos pulled out, but it's... No, the relocate!
It was a nice
King
relocate.
RD coming out and grabbing, saving the life of his Chaos Knight, though he will die himself. What a play.
I mean, yeah, he was half a second away from being dead.
Wait,
and he
wait! King RD! What the hell? Oh, man. I bet Leviathan are... kicking themselves right now. I mean, what do you even say to that? Do you just kind of accept it and let it go? I mean, what goes down to their team?
They didn't know it was a possibility. They didn't really have a vision of it, but it's very painful every time you see an IO get away like that.
Okay, well, he can't get away with it. Okay.
He can't.
Never mind.
He
doesn't have to get away with it again. Oh, boy. So, Leviathan missing out on a couple of kills, some really decent initiations, but Tisho, they're doing a great job at keeping the fights from happening, and ultimately just playing the we don't want to fight you right now because we don't feel comfortable about it game. But in the end, again, Chilan Kwa is still farming. Do you really think Leviathan are that upset about how this game's going, or are they still looking pretty decent?
I mean, they're still in a pretty good position. It's going to be a very long time till those Midases start paying off until Tisho is an actual threat, because all they can do is play the keep away game, and when you're doing that, you're not really winning.
Alright, yeah, I mean, do you think Leviathan, though, they try to force a fight right now? Do they want to fight, or do you think they're going to play the same game? Like, they're just going to bring the Rat Dota out, they're going to farm up Chilan Kwa and just play a, yeah, we don't really care type of style.
I think they're way more conservative than they used to be, because right now would be a great time to smoke into their jungle.
It looks like they're not going to do it.
They're just playing safe route.
Yeah, they're all interspersed across the map, too. They're not really exerting map control. I mean, as far as warding goes, I only see one kind of pseudo-aggressive ward, one really defensive ward at the entrance of their jungle. And then, aside from that, there's really nothing. So they don't really have that many tabs on the positioning of Tisho. They can't exactly smoke up because of this lack of vision. And how do you really get vision out? I mean, look at the Tisho with this warding. They've got three observer wards out, one sort of semi-conservative, one really defensive, and one really aggressive. And then a lot of sentries out to try to deward their side of the map. Although, just as I say that, Leviathan will deward one of their observer wards, but still two remain.
Well, that coupled with the Night Stalker vision. Getting vision on this is very hard. You kind of need to keep the pressure up in their jungle. And just it's all about pressure right now. That's what they have to do.
No, it's entirely about pressure. I mean, right now, Leviathan, I don't feel like they're exerting enough pressure. Maybe there is some pressure just because, again, I know I'm a broken record for saying this, but there is still a Medusa on the map. So that obviously is worth something. But
and there's that smoke.
Oh, okay, now they will smoke, but their target could actually be the top lane. They might have a little bit of vision, wrong side. Yeah, I think they got a little bit of vision out onto the Chaos Knight, so maybe they go for that. They're going to take the south or the east route, though. But Chaos Knight has moved his way up north into the jungle. Therence is well on out of there. Same thing with King RD. They both play as really cautiously, and it looks like it'll pay off. They don't end up getting initiated on, and actually, King RD could be in a bit of trouble. Nusham, his smoke will end. He'll spot out and run headlong into King RD. King RD's got no way to really shackle out this one. Now he does, but he's going to pop into the Glimmer Cape and go immediately for the TP. Nusham, okay, here he uses Paralyzing Cast, so he cannot stun this one out.
Yeah, he had that haste. He just got way too much space on him and just not enough vision.
And it looks like we will suffer a little bit of a pause. And yes, I do mean suffer. This game is already delayed an hour. This is game number one, and the time, an hour and a half after the game was supposed to start. So, I mean, put two and two together, we're paused up right now. I am not really feeling this. I mean, we're 23 and a half minutes into the game. The score is 9-8. We haven't seen the most kills, but we are kind of falling into this typical, you know, farming, just stay back, play it safe kind of style of Dota. Do you think we will see some more aggression? I mean, we just saw a smoke, but it didn't end up doing all that much. Or do we continue to play this? I know I'm asking you this question, like, differently worded each and every time, but I'm hoping you answer it differently.
I mean, I think we're going to see just this slow farm game for a bit, and it's going to break out eventually, and I think from there it has the potential to get ham, as the kids would say.
Radiance get ham. Coming up. They will go ham. I'm not sure get ham is the correct term.
Is it not get ham?
No, I know it's one of them will go ham, but I'm not sure.
I just
want to
acquire the ham if they don't
get
them.
Maybe they will, though. Maybe we can coin a new term. They're going to get ham onto Nusham. Oh, that rhymes. Huh. Very nice.
See, if it rhymes, it works.
Okay, Therence will bring down Nusham. Almost didn't stand a chance in that Witch Doctor. I know he was up there a while. Did he just kind of stick around? It doesn't seem like a very heads-up play for Nusham, as Witch Doctor doesn't exactly deal very well with ganks like that.
He's not the best mobility hero. Unlike Ember Spirit, who's just been pushing out this bottom lane, being a complete pest.
And the gank style was kind of interesting too, because we had King RD relocate over to his west, and then he wasn't relocating with any carry. He actually had Therence coming in from the east. So no matter what Nusham did, there was no getting away from that one. Kind of interesting how they played that.
Now here is an item that I like on Theron. He's got the Manta style up, and he can just spawn a billion illusions.
Yes, I agree with that completely. And illusions will deal more damage now that there is minus armor coming from the main hero. So really, the Manta style did end up getting inadvertently buffed with Chaos Knight, plus the buffs that Manta style had received. Other than that, so a hero with a lower mana pool like Chaos Knight can spam out more Manta styles without having to have the same cost. Plus, the illusions are up for longer. So he is going to be really happy about how this Manta style plays out. He's going to use it to try to flash farm a bit, which I really love this usage of Manta style. Even on a hero that doesn't have a lot of damage or a lot of spells that you can give to the illusions, like Medusa with Split Shot or Luna with Bouncing Blaze, you can still split push out and get at least a couple of creeps by just sending Manta style illusions for regular heroes out.
And you can always do the full send one. Hopefully they'll gank that one. But you know.
Yeah, but I don't think that happens as often because Manta style doesn't last.
It happens in my pub games all the time.
Pub games, yes, but this, I hope this isn't a pub game.
Come on, man. Leviathrow is a pub game. Like an advanced pub game. We'll give him that.
You know, that pun makes so much sense, and I've never heard it before.
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm absolutely serious.
Oh, man.
Maybe I just think too highly of Leviathan. Maybe it has been said before and I haven't really paid any attention to it, but...
Well, I think so low of everyone. It's just, that's why I think of these things.
Hopefully you don't think that low of me or you wouldn't be here, right?
No, I like you, man. It's the first time I've ever heard you, so...
Very
wow,
nice.
That's It's terrible, I guess, right?
No, it's understandable, actually.
I get that a lot. I'm doing the trolling, as the kids would say.
No trolling here. At least it's has no effect on me. I'm kind of dense to that sort of thing. Anyway, we should probably get back into the Dota action here. I say action, but really?
Farming action?
Yeah, farming action. Okay, we have about a 500 GPM right now on the Medusa with 13,000 net worth at 26 minutes. She's still at the top of the board. However, Sis is catching up. He's got that Battle Fury number one. Going for the Lincoln Sphere, though, which is pretty typical against Doom picks. I mean, it's going to slow down the late game, so we probably won't be seeing him be that super hard damage until maybe 40 minutes or so, and that's probably when more action is going to come out. But for the moment, I mean, that threshold is starting to cross where our T-Show, those Midases are starting to pay off, and maybe Leviathan kind of waited too long.
Yeah, I mean, that's what it's feeling like right now. They kind of had the opportunity to really push in, at least get a couple tier twos, maybe a Roche, maybe, you know, do that whole snowbally thing from there. But they're just letting them play the passive farm game that T-Show needed to get back in it.
Yeah, Jenkins, he's got the Blink, he's got the Aghanim Scepter, and he's got everything he needs to fight, but he's not going to fight. So what's his next item here? Do you think he feels like he needs another item, and if so, what it would be, or is this just not going to initiate? Oh, wait, now as I say that, Chibi is going to go on with Assist, but the Relocate's coming through. They'll drop a lot on him with the Laguna Blade. He'll glimpse back, or get the Glimmer Cape, and then go and Relocate on back out of here, and they will bring down King RD in the absence, but that is a Doom spent for that IO kill. 90 seconds on cooldown. It will allow them a little bit of space to go after this TNT mid, so perhaps it's worth it, but it's up to T-Show to defend this one. Do they actually go in? They've got a Winter's Curse. Maybe they can.
No, I think they just keep up the split pressure. They can't really bite into that right now. And I'm not a huge fan of the Doom Waste for IO, but I mean, it kills a kill. But I mean, this is beautiful, though. They're pushing high ground. They're just really asserting that pressure.
Actually really surprising, considering Francois, he's going to try to Mantis style out of that Splinter Shot, but it's not going to really mean all that much. He actually doesn't actually get the god.
Yeah, and they have to back.
He has to go bottom.
Jeremy.
That's a Phantasm spin, isn't it?
I believe so, yes, yeah. That was.
Spends a Phantasm to go after that tier 3 bottom, only brings it down to half HP. Same kind of deal with the mid tier 3, but not much was wasted. And Shibby, that's not exactly what you're supposed to do right now.
Well, Shibby's also trolling.
Is he? Is that actually a troll, or was that a legit mistake?
It was probably a mistake.
Okay. I trust you. I don't know if I should trust you, but I trust you.
You probably shouldn't. Many people have made that mistake before.
Good to know. Boots of Travel will get picked up by Jenkins. Pretty decent pickup, but again, I mean, he's building to a late game and not really building for now anymore. Boots of Travel and the Link, the Tranquil Boots. That's a pretty interesting combination he's got going on there.
Well, I like it. I see people do this all the time before selling your original boots. He's got the huge regen. He's got a Gematrier site too, so they've got like a lot of map vision. But with the darkness, it's still very hard to keep it.
Darkness and now an Aghanim Scepter on Baga. He's got map hack vision right now, and it's looking pretty good. Do they give him a gem here and look for the gem vision, Trusei vision for some of these Z wardings, or are they just gonna? I answer my own question. They will buy the gem. And they'll probably throw into the bagger really soon.
Got a Scotty up on CLQ, though. I love this item on Medusa. Super tanky, a lot of damage, that's slow.
So yeah, we'll push into the top tier 1 tower. Theron's doing a pretty decent sum of damage. Inert is there, supplying what little right clicks he can, but the big thing here is that they're getting some extra map control. They want Leviathan, they're going for the Roshan, and by all means, they should have it.
Yeah, this is a pretty quick Roche, even though they don't have too much minus armor.
Yeah, not to go. Sis! Sis, he took the Roshan and he took the Aegis! There's no freaking way!
And Leviathan lose their courier. Nope, that was T-Show.
Yeah, he did lose his courier in that process.
Totally, though. It's a good exchange. I'll trade
it. That's a very good exchange. How the hell do you accomplish that? Oh, now the relocate, they're going into Shibby, they'll pop the Winter's Curse. And things going very south very quickly for the Leviathan boys as scores 10-10 at 31 minutes. But that fight just went drastically south for them very quickly. It wasn't even a fight, it was just a bunch of really well-played maneuvers by Tisho. Yeah.
And a great pick.
And a great pick. And a great Roshan. And a great Aegis.
Looks like it's going to be a great tier 2 mid.
And a great tier 2 mid, yep. Maybe even more, though. Qilan Qua still a bit difficult to push into. He's only got that Scotty Mantis style, so he's by all means not invincible. So he's going to be kind of hard to bring down. He'll avoid him out. Get him with the Searing Chains. Arctic Burn taking a lot of damage, but it's all going to his mana pool.
Yeah, but he's not really caring.
Yeah, he's just sitting up large and in charge. Playing it aggressively, and you know, I think Tisho are respecting the Medusa. They've got the Aegis Mortality, but they're not gonna push it right now. I think maybe they're looking for a pickoff with a relocate, which will be back up very shortly. Or perhaps they just felt that wasn't quite their fight and they're gonna back off, regroup, and go again in a different lane.
Yeah, we'll see if they go box. They already have that tier 3 down to about half HP.
Yeah, that might be the smartest maneuver, especially for breaking high ground, though. So the argument can be made that perhaps the tier 2 would be best to break down because that would allow you to bring down all three sets of racks should you take a good fight on Leviathan's side of the map. But, I mean, easy tier 3 or a tier 2. It's ultimately Leviathan, our Tisho's call, and we'll have to see exactly what they decide to do. Leviathan not really looking like they're in the most prime of position here, as the net worth advantage has gone back to equilibrium. Experience down in excess of 4,000 in favor of Tisho. A Heart of Terrestre now being picked up by Ferrix. And Sis, with the Lincoln Sphere done, he is now going to go into that Daedalus build.
Yeah, he's ready to get his Chrysalis out. He's getting there.
Qilan Qua going toe-to-toe with Sis. It looks like Shibby came in looking for Yule, but wasn't able to find it. Now Qilan Qua, Jenkins, Flying Zebra, they're all there, ready to push, but they've got to be careful of this Rat Dota, as it's only Lilkin right now, and they've got King RD down there as well, but Leviathan aren't forcing anything. And with that said, that means Tisho, they can just kind of hang back, farm out, split push out, and not have to worry about being pressured for time.
I feel like this is very lacking in respect of what Tisho have at the moment. Between that split push and the Aegis, I don't feel like they should be this aggressive right now.
Well, they're just going to do it. They push up, it's a damage in tier 3. Just as soon as Qilan Qua starts hitting it, he backs off as a glyph gets spent. Mantis style being popped for the bottom lane, and Jenkins will make quick work of those illusions, although not quite quick enough. The tower will drop to a little under half HP, and Leviathan all back off. Time wasted or what? Do you think they had some
a little bit of time wasted, but it's a decent glyph burn nonetheless. So the next time they push out before this Aegis is over, like, they could go back in base and actually get a tier 3 or maybe bot tier 2. I'd like bot tier 2 personally.
So Qilan Qua is building into a Daedalus of his own. What do you think about this?
I love it.
You love it?
Yes.
Okay,
crit
so you
damage.
Just wanted to build straight up damage.
Straight damage. Get a rapier
straight
next. Damage. Just go, yeah, go crazy.
Do it. No lifesteal. Just get a rapier?
Yeah, just get a rapier.
Huh.
Doom can get lifesteal.
You know, a Vlad's pick up on their team. Vlad's is all a really good item, by the way. I love that item. Especially now that it gives the regen to the range, so. I mean, it could be a decent item to allow him to go straight for that rapier. I can't tell if you're trolling or not with that, but I do tend to agree with it, to be perfectly honest. I mean, Qilan Qua. What else
is
he buying this to have the same impact?
Yeah, for damage, not much. He can go defensive, but they're not really hitting him with too many targeted abilities, so he doesn't really need that Lincoln Sphere.
Nor BKB, so I guess, you know, it could be his next prime option, but I think he finishes that Daedalus first, looking for the crits before he starts stacking up the raw damage. We'll get a little bit more DPS out of that, doing it that way, but right now, it looks like Leviathan are just looking to do that same thing. They push down mid with no glyph left. They go after the tier 3, and they should get it by all means. Sis is hanging on the bottom lane. He's got an activate remnant. It's not quite back in base. Qilan Qua is going after this Rax, and so far, It doesn't seem like Tishou have an adequate answer for this call. Sis will still try to split push. Jenkins goes in. He pops the link. Is looking for the Doom, but won't get it off. Meanwhile, TP out. Looks like Sis will be joining the fight. Jilan Kwa is still just manning up for the racks, and then she's just going to get it. He pops out with the Stone Gaze, and he might actually just straight up bring down Lil Kin. He's still going after that racks. Lil Kin's dead. Jilan Kwa's hanging out and dealing the deeps. Baga is going to be on the run, but Shibby having no trouble bringing him down. What just happened? Leviathan forced the issue on Tishou, and the greatest mistake of their lives as they give up their racks. They cannot bring down this Medusa, at least not yet. He'll pop into the Mantis style, doing a decent stuff. Lil Kin has bought back. Now in comes the Winter's Curse, but the Death Ward. Lil Kin still alive. Jilan Kwa not going to be as lucky. He gets taken down. Finally, he will have buy back Nushan. Not quite so lucky. He's not going to be able to purchase himself another life in this game, but Leviathan. They get the melee and the ranged racks in the mid lane, and they lose. Oh, wait, they lost their bottom racks. Okay, that just happened.
Yeah, they lost their bottom racks, but they got the mid racks, and they got two buybacks in the Wyvern and the IO. That's going to put them so far behind. All in all, it's pretty even, pretty washy. Although I'd favor Leviathan a little bit more.
Really? I'm going to favor Tishou a little bit more. To be perfectly honest, I mean, take a look at which lane got raxed, right? Tishou, they lose their mid racks. The easiest lane to push out, and... you know, that one's going to get racks probably next anyway, because that's the most popular lane to just straight up push after you win a fight. Meanwhile, Tishou, they get their bottom racks taken out, which is a much longer lane to try to push out from. It's a little bit more defensive. I think the harder lane to push out would be the top lane of racks, but even that one's now missing a tier 3. What the hell?
Valvo, please. You know... you explained it right, though. I will agree with you now. I think Tishou did come ahead on that, even though they did expend two buybacks.
Yeah, and the buybacks were on the supports. So, really, you lose your two supports, they'll probably hang back in the fight anyway. I think the big issue with that one fight is the supports got kind of caught in a really shitty position. Or should I say a really shibby position. As they get brought down, one just has to go toe-to-toe with Jilan Kwa, which a Winter Wyvern will not win that matchup. He just takes a little bit too much damage. And Io, I don't know what happened to Io, but I'm pretty sure it's something to do with Shibby on the Lina. But, I mean, right now, the other buybacks, do they have it on the rest of their cores? They've got one on Chaos Knight. None on Sis, but he's only about 160 gold away from it. So the rest of the cores do have it, though all three cores from Leviathan have buyback as well. It's not too big of a difference there. But, again, I don't have to refresh the kicker because I explained it, but just where the racks happened makes all of the difference in the world. And now Tishou will start to put a little bit of pressure on the mid lane as it looks like they are trying to reconnect into this game. That was a pretty intense little disconnect they got there.
Yeah, I wonder if they're all in the same house. Do you know about that?
Probably are. Most teams in South America, they usually play either at a LAN cafe or at a gaming house, so probably something like that. I don't think it'd be like a countrywide outage there. That'd be really weird.
That would actually be great.
That'd
finally
be
get those South Americans off my East server, you know?
Oh my god.
You're not allowed to say that? Is that...
no.
Is that a no-no?
No, you're really not.
Okay.
If this were like 2-on-8 teams fighting each other, maybe. But we've got a lot of SA representative in this...
I love South America. Beautiful countries.
Dude, amazing cocaine. You gotta wear the I Heart SA shirt next time. We'll put you on camera. You'll make amends. Looks like everyone reconnected back in the game here. So, Tishou, they get some time to catch their thoughts and resume. Though it looks like in that time, Sis decided, yep, this is not a place I want to be in. So he just activates Fire Emblem to get himself back out. And Tishou, Jenkins. Okay. Oh, Leviathan. We lost a couple of players.
I guess they weren't good.
I don't think it's network, guys. I don't think it's Reborn. I think it's just Leviathan being lazy. What do we call him? Leviathrow? I think that's pretty applicable to this game right now. I mean, I won't say they threw a huge advantage. Net worth, they only had about a 5,000 advantage. It's still equilibrium. Experience, they only had a 5,000 advantage as well. Now it's about 7,500 in favor of Tishou, so not a huge throw by any stretch, but they had an advantage and they lost it. Now they're going to lose more. Jenkins and a whole host of trouble. He will be brought down. He does have buyback, but I don't don't think he really wants to spend it. And now Tisho, they've got the option of trying to force it.
No, but giving away a gem like that, it's, I think it was their gem, but still giving them gem, their gem back. It's no bueno.
Chat just caught up to the mass disconnect, by the way. It's almost poetic to watch. Just, you know, a little tidbit of information there. Baga?
That's a lot of hate.
I don't know if you could call that hate, just a lot of, something. A lot of something. The tier 2 tower is going to be pressured in the mid lane. Tisho are making their way down. They're looking to try to bring it down. This could be a pretty decent pickup if they get it. So I don't think Leviathan are going to give it up without a fight. They've got to be very careful, though, because Tisho have this option of just straight up split pushing this one out. Top lane's pushing in. In fact, okay, there is a cavalry, an entire cavalier union of Chaos Knight Creeps. They'll pop a Chain Frost to bring it all down. And even that takes a little bit of time to rip through it. In the meantime, their tier 2 tower is taking quite a bit of damage, though they won't actually bring it down. This isn't the last time that Tisho can do this. They can just continue to put some split pressure on, and eventually something's going to die.
Yeah, I mean, this is kind of the point that Leviathan didn't want them to get to. They're just way too mobile. And, you know, they didn't do enough in the early game. That was the real problem here.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. All those times that we talked about them, oh, they were just waiting because they're confident. Oh, they're just waiting because they think they have the late game. Now it's become, well, shit, they waited too long. And you hit the nail on the head. They just did not quite do enough to warrant this sort of carefree play. Now, Qilan Qua is still one of their insurance plans for this game. I think they're looking for that Divine Rapier pickup that you mentioned. I would love to see that, by the way. But if he goes any other item, what would you think it'd be?
Any other item? Maybe a Maelstrom? Maybe.
I could see that. I mean, if you're going against lanes of Super Creeps and Mega Creeps, if push were to come to shove, then Mjolnir is one of the better items to deal with it. Mjolnir Vlads, that's kind of what you have to have on your team if you get forced in a situation like that. Even though she's got Split Shot, the extra little bit of damage from Mjolnir as well as attack speed is definitely helpful. Plus, you know, there are no natural defusal carriers on Tisho, so it's not like they're going to defusal off the shield. So, Sis will grab himself another Aegis from Mortality. That's, I mean, his second Aegis. That's pretty decent considering the first one was an amazing steal, the second one coming a little bit easier. But now that he's got Aegis, how do Leviathan deal with a push like this? They can just send Sis up and do that whole split pusher thing, but now it's a little bit more confidence. Got any thoughts on that?
Oh, no, sorry. I was not paying attention.
Ah, I get it. It's 41 minutes into the game, 13-14, all right? We've had 27 kills in a 41-minute game after an hour-long delay.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is. It's not you at all. You're doing a great job.
Thanks for blowing up my ego, man. It's
really fantastic,
helpful.
Man. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be here.
If it wasn't for Corey, you wouldn't be here.
Yes.
Anyway, Lotus Orb gets picked up by Baga. I think he's just running out of items to pick up, maybe. Do they have an Assault Kuros already? They do. Do they have a Vladimir's Offering? They do not. So maybe a Vlad's would be a little bit of a better pickup, but with the Lotus Orb, they're just going to push in the mid lane. Do Leviathan just want to...
I don't think all laning is the play.
Yeah, they're going to lose their entire base. If this does not work, then they just straight up lose. Nope, it does work. They force... Oh, wait. TP canceled, maybe? I don't know. Looks like Shivy's going to go ahead and bring down Winter Wyvern. There's no buyback on him, by the way, even though he's got his ultimate. Sis, could be in a bit of trouble. They're going to go ahead and bring down that Aegis. Newsham, what's going on here? It looks like Therence is going to pop a bunch of illusions. Now TP back, but he's not TPing back with all of those illusions, so he's going to be alone and against the world, but they bring down Shibby, and Qilan Qua, this all-in, is not quite working. The Chain Frost is coming through, and it bounce between Sis and Therence, but Sis going down is not going to mean all that much, and the all-in from Leviathan has ended an absolute disaster. As they only bring down one tier 4, they lose their top racks, they lose a tier 4 mid. Tier 2 is still standing, but not worth it at all. Everyone from Leviathan buy back, by the way. Do they all in again? What's the plan here?
It looks like they're trying to all in again, but again, it's not the play. Like, if they go in again, they just lose the game, which I think they lose the game anyways. It's very hard to come back from this position that they're in right now.
Q Shilan Kwa with plate mail. No divine rapier. Zeng is now in a bit of trouble. If he dies here, this game is pretty much over. And I almost
hate to call it early, but yeah that might be the game.
I'm not going to call it early, but let's take a review of the situation right now. Can Leviathan really win without Doom?
Like, yes?
Do you think so? Because they have to TP back. They're not going to get anything for this push. They lose the Doom. They've got nothing. 70 seconds before the Doom's back in this fight. Tisho might just be able to straight run down mid, bring down that last tier too, and I don't think they've got much on Leviathan to deal with it. But
I mean, I didn't say they're waiting for Phantasm. But it could happen. Anything could happen.
They have to wait for Phantasm, I think. That's one of their only ways to bring down the Medusa. At least quickly. Other than that, they just have to try to hope and they can take a long fight against them, which is very hard to do, especially with Chain Frost and Death Ward going back and forth between everyone. So that is an Aghanim Scepter Death Ward, by the way. That's a pretty big pickup for Nushan, though. He doesn't have level 16 ultimate. He will still get 4 bounces. Quite as much damage, but it's something. It's everything he uses. Like, though, you will see a little bit of pressure. Both top and bottom pushing in. Therence now, he's got Phantasm. Will pop it up, gets 4 illusions. Now brings in Shilan Kwa. And just like that, Shilan Kwa getting destroyed, but he will still survive after the end, all said and done. Therence taking a bit of damage, but he's got the Heart of Teresk and the Lotus Orb. Now, the Winter's Curse and the Shilan Kwa, they'll force stab him in the middle of 3. And comes a Sleight of Fist, and Therence, he just brings back Flying Zebra and brings him down. Nushan, short to follow as well. The Tier 4 has all but dropped. All that's left to do is bring down the Aegis. Jenkins comes in with a Doom of the Century, but Therence does not care one bit. He turns and fights. He's going to go after Shippy now. Therence is actually taking a good chunk of damage. Jenkins is still alive. This Doom is persisting, and he's just going to go straight down here. He has no way of living through this. Maybe he does. No, he will go down. He's got buyback as Shilan Kwa is able to repel Sis for the time being. The racks still stand, only a tier 4 has fell, and now Shilan Kwa could actually bring down Sis. No, the Glimmer Cape will protect the Ember Spirit. They'll turn around, maybe try to fight, but it doesn't look like it's going to happen. Meanwhile, Baga, he's still here punching the Ancient. Same thing with Therence. He's going to make his way back on in as soon as possible. Beach is traveling into the bottom lane. Shilan Kwa taking a lot of damage. He pops into the Mana Style, but Therence doesn't care. He's going to bring him back, look for the damage, and Shilan Kwa calls a GG, well played, as he's bursting through multiple realities. That's it. The Ancient drops, and game number one will go to Leviathan. Any final words you got to say before we wait on for game number two?
Yes, the game went actually to Tisho, not Leviathan.
Yes, it did. It did go to Tisho. Thank you for being here, by the way. Game number one going to Tisho. You could see where my bias was at, by the way, from that one call. Anyway, guys, thank you very much for catching us so far. Tisho will take a 1-0 victory right now, but we will have a game number two coming up, so stick around. Don't change the channel. I'm Chicago Ted at TedCast on Twitter. Joining me is Spudnik at Spudnik225. Did I get that right?
Yeah, that's about right.
That's about right. All right, guys. So once again, thank you for watching. Game number two coming up next.